Class 5 IMO Level 2 Mathematics Question Number 1 Which of the following statements is correct? A. A square has only 2 equal sides. No, a square has 4 equal sides. So this is wrong. C. A square has 2 lines of symmetry. No, a square has 4 lines of symmetry. So this is also wrong. D. A rectangle has 4 lines of symmetry. Wrong. A rectangle has only 2 lines of symmetry. A rectangle is not diagonally symmetrical. B. A rectangle has 2 pairs of equal sides. Yes, a rectangle has 2 pairs of equal sides. Mathematics question number 2. 3 Roman numerals A, B and C each having V only once in the place shown. Other 2 Roman numerals are either I or X or both. First, let's see the A option. VXX cannot be possible. In Roman numerals, if a symbol is placed before a greater value symbol, means you have to subtract the smaller value from the greater value. Here, X is 10 and V is 5. We cannot subtract 10 minus 5 because there is already a symbol for 5. So this is wrong. VII is possible. That is equal to 7. XVI is also possible. That is 16. XIV is also possible, that is 14. So, which of the following statements is true? A. Statement is true because the smallest number is A. Mathematics question number 3. How many 6 are there in the given equation? Since all of the other equations except 3.75 are in fractional form, we will convert that also into fractional form, which is equal to 15 by 4. Now, we have to convert these mixed fraction into improper fraction and then take LCM and then add them. If we add, we get 56 by 4, which is equal to 14. Now, we have to find how many 6ths are there in 14. Number of 1 by 6 in 14 is equal to 14 divided by 1 by 6. Since you cannot divide a fraction, we have to reciprocal it and multiply it, which is equal to 14 into 6 by 1, that is equal to 84. There are 84 sixths in the given equation. Mathematics question number 4. On Monday, the temperature was 20 degrees Celsius. On Tuesday, it had gone down by 3 degrees Celsius. So on Tuesday, it will be 17 degrees Celsius. And on Wednesday, it had gone up by 8 degrees Celsius. What was the temperature on Wednesday? So, it was 17 degrees Celsius on Tuesday. On Wednesday, it had gone up by 8 degrees. So, 17 plus 8, which is equal to 25 degrees Celsius. Mathematics question number 5. The given graph shows number of cupcakes sold by Tamia on 5 consecutive days. What fraction of total cupcakes is sold on Wednesday? In order to find how many cupcakes were sold on all 5 days, we have to add each day. If we do that, we'll get 85 cupcakes sold in 5 days. So, fraction of cupcakes sold on Wednesday is equal to number of cupcakes sold on Wednesday by total number of cupcakes sold on 5 days, which is equal to 25 by 85. Equivalent fraction of 25 by 85 is equal to 5 by 70, that is B. Mathematics question number 6. Karan spent 1 by 3 of his salary and saved 1500 rupees every month. How much did he earn in a year? Karan spent 1 by 3 of his salary, therefore the remaining is 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 of his salary is equal to 1500. 2 by 3 into total salary is equal to 1500. So, 1500 into 3 by 2, which is equal to 2250 rupees every month. So, they have asked how much did he earn in a year. So, there are 12 months in a year. So, we have to multiply his salary for 1 month into 12, which is equal to 27,000. Mathematics question number 7. A towel costs 59 rupees 90 paise and a bar of soap costs 12 rupees 40 paise. Mr. Kapoor bought 2 towels and 3 bars of soap. How much did she pay altogether? We have to calculate how many for 2 towels and then calculate how much for 3 soaps. And if we calculate that and add that, we'll get 157 rupees. Mathematics question number 8. In the given figure, what fraction of total area is shaded? We'll take this rectangle as rectangle A, this square as B, and this other square as C. Area of shaded figure is equal to area of rectangle A plus area of square B plus area of square C. If we substitute the values and add, we will get 74 square centimeter as the area of shaded figure. They have asked, what is the fraction of total area that is shaded? So in order to find fraction, we have to find the total area of the rectangle that is equal to 150 square centimeter. So fraction of shaded figure to the total area is equal to 74 by 150, which is equal to 37 by 75, that is B. Mathematics question number 9. Anita filled a tank with 8 liters 75 ml of oil, a can with 3 liters 25 ml of oil, a bottle with 725 ml of oil. How much quantity of oil did Anita have altogether? If we add all these values, we will get 12 liters 475 ml of oil. That is A. Mathematics question number 10. An empty jar weighs 3 kg 125 gram. Reshma puts some marbles of weight 54 gram each. Now the total weight of the jar is 4 kg 97 gram. How many marbles did Reshma put in the jar? An empty jar is equal to 3 kg 125 gram. Weight of jar after adding marbles is equal to 4 kg 97 gram. So weight of marbles is equal to 4 kg 97 gram minus 3 kg 125 gram, that is equal to 972 gram. So the weight of all the marbles Reshma put is equal to 927 gram. To find the weight of one marble, we have to divide the total weight of the marbles by one marble. That is equal to 18 marbles. So she put 18 marbles in the jar. Mathematics question number 11. When symbol is subtracted from 65 thousandths, the answer is 150 tenths less than 62 thousandths. How many hundredths is the symbol? So 65,000 minus the symbol is equal to 60,500. So the symbol is equal to 4,500. That is 45 hundredths. Mathematics question number 12. There are 125 passengers in a train. 20 of them are children, while the rest of them are adults. If 5 by 7 of the adults are men, then what fraction of the total passengers in the train are women? In order to find how many adults are there, we have to subtract the total from 20, as the 20 are children. So there are 105 adults. 5 by 7 of 1 by 5 are men. That is 75. 75 adults are men. Then what fraction of the total passengers in the train are women? In order to find how many women are there, we have to subtract how many men are there from the total adults. That is equal to 30. We have to write this in fraction. So fraction of women to the total passengers in the train is equal to 30 by 125. That is equal to 6 by 25. Mathematics question number 13. In the value, the sum of place values of 5 is dash more than the sum of place values of 3. Sum of place values of 5 is equal to 5050.5. And the sum of place value of 3 is equal to 3.03. So the sum of place values of 5 is 5047.47 more than the sum of value of 3. So that is B. Mathematics question number 14. Shikha makes a profit of rupees 85 crore 3,55,039. Her profits can be written in the numerals as B. Mathematics question number 15. Which of the following shapes can be tessellated? Only S can be tessellated. The meaning of tessellations is that the figure can be repeated many times with no gap in between them. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe. Hit that like button and turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.